Oh, okay, class, we are now on the topic of sources of obligations. Okay, Article 1157 of the Civil Code provides that obligations arise from or may come from either law, contracts, quasi-contracts, delicts, or also called crimes or acts or omissions punished by law, and quasi-delicts, also called culpa aquiliana or torts. Okay, so under Article 1157, these are the five sources of obligations. Okay, class, dito manggagaling ang obligations na i-discuss natin in our course. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, according to 1157. Pero if you look at it, class, there are actually only two sources of obligation, namely law and contracts. Why? Because this number 3, number 4, and number 5 are provided for by law, and therefore are part of the first source, which is law. For example, class, quasi-contracts is found under Article 2142 to 2175 of the Civil Code. Okay? Therefore, this quasi-contract is also under the first source, which is law. Okay? Law din ito, provided for by law under the Civil Code, Article 2142 to 2175, which will be discussed as we go along with our course. Okay. Number 4, class, itong delicts are also found in law, particularly in the Revised Penal Code and other penal laws. So these are separate laws that separate from the Civil Code. Okay, these are laws that punishes crimes. Okay, nandun lahat yung mga delicts or crimes. And therefore, because of that, this number 4 is also part of law. Okay, so number 5, quasi-delicts, culpa aquiliana or torts, is found under Article 2176 to 2194 of the Civil Code. Oh, therefore, this is also law. Okay, so 3, 4, and 5 is actually part of our law. So that some author would emphasize that obligations only arise from two sources, law and contracts. Okay, yan yung 3, 4, 5 plus. Part yan ng law. So, obligations arise from law are also called legal obligations. Okay, law, legal. While contracts are considered law between the parties. Okay, so when you enter into a contract, you are actually making law among yourselves. Okay, the parties lang sa parties. So, while contract is not a law, it is like a law when it comes to the parties who are contracting with each other. Okay, for example, you and I, okay, enter into a contract of sale that I will buy your cell phone for 10,000 pesos. So that agreement, okay, is the law between us. Okay, but it is not actually law insofar as other persons are concerned. So that is why contracts is different from law. The contracts also only acts like a law between the contracting parties. Okay, so contracts, okay, must be complied with in good faith. Okay, and this is because between the contracting parties, class, contracts serves as a law between them, and therefore they must comply with it in good faith. Okay, contracts. Okay, sa contracts, class, which is part 2 of our course. This is advanced knowledge lang. All persons may enter into whatever kind of contract they want, for as long as it is not against the law, morals, good customs, public order, and public policy. So ito yung limitations. Okay, pwede kayong mag-agree whatever you want under the sun, for as long as hindi siya against the law, morals, good customs, public order, and public policy. Okay, this concept will be discussed sa part 2 of our course on the subject of contracts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the sources of obligations. But for purposes of the board exam class, if you are asked kung what are the sources of obligations, you enumerate this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ha? Ha? Pang bar exam lang yung answer na there are actually two kinds of sources. It's law and contracts because 3, 4, and 5 is part of law. Pang bar exam na class, pang abogado na siyang answer. Pero for purposes of the board exam, sa CPA board exam, if you are asked what are the sources of obligation, you enumerate this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Law is, obligations from law, arising from law is also called obligation ex lege. Those coming from contracts are called obligation ex contracto. Okay, quasi contracts, obligation ex quasi contracto. Obligation ex maleficio or ex delicto ang tawag sa delicts. While quasi-delicts are called obligation ex quasi-maleficio or quasi-delicto. Okay. Yan yung mga other names na class. Basically, bugon mo sa board exam. Just know na some authors also call these sources as in their Latin names. Okay. So, sa quasi-contract class, there are actually two kinds, negotiorum gestio and solution debiti. Okay. For purposes of the board exam, you memorize these two class, negotiorum gestio and solution debiti. Okay. Because actually, there are several kinds of quasi-contracts. Okay. Ang number 3 niyan class are different examples, which are really very negligible naman, because they are like this. Negotiorum gestio and solution debiti. So, for purposes of the board exam, ito lang ang i-focus ninyo. Okay? Kung gusto nyo mag-abogado, i-memorize nyo rin yung number 3, which is very tedious na and very, very detailed na. Okay? Okay? Pero sa board exam class, ito lang ang tinatanong. Okay, negotiorum gestio is found in Article 2144 to 2145 of the Civil Code. Solution in debiti is found under Article 2154 to 2163. Okay, what is negotiorum gestio? Negotiorum gestio is also called unauthorized management by an officious officer. Officious manager, I mean. Okay. What is negotiorum gestio? When a person voluntarily takes charge of another's abandoned business or property without the owner's authority, but done for his benefit, reimbursement must be made to the gestor for necessary and useful expenses. Okay? Gestor class ang tawag sa person who voluntarily takes charge of the property or business of another person. Okay? Sa negosyorum gestio class, ganito yan. There is a property or may isang business. Tapos yung may-ari, wala. Wala siya dyan. Siguro nasa Amerika siya o sa Europe. Ang tawag sa kanya, absentee. Kasi wala siya dito, absentee. And then this person, nakapitbahay niya, okay, for the benefit of, kasi may concern siya doon sa absentee, wala silang contract. Pero the neighbor took charge of the property or the business of the absentee. Okay. Anong purpose niya class? Para maprotektahan yung business and then your property kasi wala doon yung may-ari. Okay. So, ang purpose dito class is hindi niya pagkapirahan yung property or yung business, kundi concern ito. Isang taong concern sa tao, sa kanyang kapwa-tao na wala dito. Okay. So, negotiorum gestio. He took care of the business or the property of that person na wala dito. Okay? Para kanino class? For the benefit of that person na wala dito. Okay? So, dahil dyan, this person na nag-take care of the business or ng property, who is also called the gestor, okay, may have incurred useful and necessary expenses for purposes of managing the business or the property. So that, pagbalik nung absentee, yung tao na wala dito, yung may-ari, okay, kahit wala silang contract class, is at it the law says it is considered as if meron silang contract, kaya tawag quasi contract, parang may contract, quasi contract. Ang tawag sa quasi contract na ito is negotiorum gestio. Okay, pagbalik ng absentee dito, yung may-ari, he is obliged by law, ang law ang nagsabi na kailangan niya bayaran si gestor for anong bayaran class, necessary and useful expenses only. Necessary and useful expenses only. Ibig sabihin, yung mga expenses lang na kailangan and useful for the taking care of the business or the property. Example, sa property tayo class. Okay. Nakita mo yung property ng kapitbahay mo, nasusunog. Wala ka dito, wala siya dito. So you take care. Okay. Bumili ka ng balde, fire extinguisher para patayin yung sunog. Okay. Then after the sunog, after sa sunog, okay, bumili ka ng mga cactus, ng mga, ng baljang, nilagay mo doon sa palibot ng bahay para gumanda yung bahay, yung palibot. Okay? Ang necessary and useful expenses na bayaran lang nung may-ari pagbalik niya, yun lang fire extinguisher at saka yung pail na binili mo para pampatay ng sunog. Okay? Yung cactus, yung baljang na pang decoration lang sa palibot, those are not necessary and useful expenses. Okay, class? So, under the quasi-contract of negotiation gestio, even if wala silang contract, the absentee, when he comes back, has the obligation to pay the gestor for the necessary and useful expenses only. Okay? Extravagant, unnecessary, luxurious expenses are not part of the obligation to be paid. Okay, yun lang necessary and useful expenses class. So take note, this negotiorum gestio is also called unauthorized management. And do not forget class, ha, the purpose dito ng gestor is to take care of the property for the benefit of the absentee. Okay? Okay. Number two, the quasi-contract of solution in debite, also called undue payment. Okay. Ang negosyon gestio class, ang tawag unauthorized management. Ang solution debite, ang tawag undue payment or payment by mistake. Okay. When something is received, when there is no right to demand it, it was unduly delivered through mistake, the person who received the thing has the obligation to return it. Of course, class. For example, ang kakontrata ko si Pedro. Sabi ko, Pedro, I oblige myself to deliver to you my cellphone. Okay. So kami ni Pedro ang may contract. Pero yung cellphone nabigay ko kay Juan. Kasi I taught siya si Pedro. Take note, class, ha, ang agreement ko is with Pedro, but I mistakenly delivered the cellphone to Juan. Juan, who is not the person that I have a contract with, wala kaming contract, pero sa kanya ko na-deliver by mistake yung cellphone. Juan now, under the quasi-contract of solution indemnity, has the obligation to give back, to return the cellphone. Why? Kahit na wala kaming contract, merong quasi-contract. Under quasi-contract, okay, one has the obligation to deliver back, to return the cell phone. Okay. Applicable din dito class yung sobrang bayad. For example, may utang ko sa iyo 100, ang nabigay ko sa iyo 1,000. Tapos na umalis ako. Hindi ko nakuha yung sukli. Ang contract natin is only utang na 100. Okay, dahil 900 na sobra, dahil 1,000 yung binayad ko eh. Ang contract natin, mga utang, is only up to 100. Yung 900, hindi na yung nakasali sa contract natin. So, even if may contract tayo ng 100, dun sa 900, wala tayong contract. Ang tawag dun sa 900, you are obliged to give it back to me, ang sobra na 900 under the solutio in debite, not under the contract. Kasi yung contract, ang cover niya 100 lang. Yung solution in debite, yung 900. Wala tayong contract doon sa 900. Okay, you have the obligation to return it to me. Okay. So this is the other name of solution debite, undue payment and payment by mistake. Okay, to recap class, there are two kinds of quasi-contract. Negotiorum gestio, also called unauthorized management. And number two, solution in debite, which is also called undue payment or payment by mistake. Okay, take note, sa board exam, minsan ang ginagamit nilang word ito, unauthorized management. Under the quasi-contract of unauthorized management. Okay, negotiorum gestio ang ibig sabihin niyan class. Or, the board exam will say, under the quasi-contract of undue payment, or under the contract of under the quasi-contract of payment by mistake, ang ginamit niya class, solution in debite. Okay? So what are the guiding principle in quasi-contracts class? Kaling negotiorum gestio and solution in debite. The guiding principle is that, okay, guiding principle meaning, bakit babayaran ni absentee pagdating niya si gestor na hindi naman niya inutusan na mag-manage ng kanyang business or ng kanyang property. Okay, di ba? And then yung under solution in debite, bakit isa sa uli ng nakatanggap yung na-deliver sa kanya by mistake na hindi naman niya kasalanan yun. Okay? The principle their class, under the law, the principle kung bakit sila na-obliged to return or to pay is because under the laws, under Article 2142, okay, to the end that no one shall be unjustly enriched or benefited at the expense of another. Okay? So, dapat walang ma-enrich or makinabang at the expense of another person, at the disadvantage of another person. So, ibig sabihin, class, ayaw ng batas na mag-take advantage ka with another person. So, anything na na-deliver to you by mistake, you have to return it under solution debite. Kapag ka may taong concern na nag-take care sa properties mo or business mo dahil wala ka, you have to repay necessary and useful expenses. Okay? Bilang pakita na hindi ka nag-take advantage sa kanila. So, this is the guiding principle in quasi-contracts. Take note class, walang contract sa quasi-contract pa sa quasi-contract nga eh. Kailangan may obligation because of this principle. So, obligations arising from crime or delicts. Ito yung mga criminal acts class. Under Article 100 of the Revised Penal Code, okay, ang sabi doon, every person is criminally liable is also civilly liable. Okay, class? Ano ibig sabihin yan? Pag nagpatay ka ng tao, you will be, number one, ikukulong ka dahil nakapatay ka, you are criminally liable. And then you will be ordered to pay the victim because you are also civilly liable. Ang penalty kasi sa criminal liability class is kulong, di ba? Para sa civil liability, civilly liable ka, you have to pay damages. Kaya every person, sabi ng Revised Penal Code, may dalawang liability. One is criminal liability, number two is civil liability. So every person na nag-commit ng crime has the obligation also to pay damages. So civil liability arising from crimes includes restitution. Ibalik yung kinuha mo kung meron man. Reparation of damages. Okay. Bayaran mo yung damages na nagawa mo. And indemnification for consequential damages. Okay, discuss natin ito class. Restitution, reparation, and indemnification. For example, nagnakaw ka. Pinasok mo yung bahay, sinira mo ang pinto. Kinuha mo ang TV. Umalis ka. Bukas yung pinto, siyempre, sinira mo eh. Ngayon, pumasok yung aso ng kapitbahay doon sa bahay at kinain yung mga pagkain doon sa mesa. Okay? Tapos nahuli ka. Because you have done a crime, you are criminally liable. Makukulong ka. And then you are also civilly liable. Anong bayaran mo sa civil liability? Restitution? Ibalik mo yung TV. I-restitute. I-return. Yan ang ibig sabihin ng restitution. Number two, reparation of damages. Bayaran mo yung pinto na sinira mo. Ipa-repair yun eh. Reparation na damage mo eh. And indemnification for consequential damages. Bayaran mo din yung pagkain sa mesa na kinain ng aso. Dahil consequential yun eh. Consequence yun ang ginawa mo eh. Kahit hindi mo sinadya yun, kung hindi mo sana sinira yung pinto, hindi sana papasok yung aso na kakainin yung pagkain sa mesa. Okay, so, yun ang ibig sabihin ng indemnification for consequential damages. So, lahat ng consequence ng act mo, bayaran mo din. Ayan ang ibig sabihin yan. So, any person is criminally liable, is also civilly liable, and under civil liability, bayaran niya, number one, restitution, ibalik kung may kinuha. Number two, reparation of damages, okay? Bayaran niya yung manasira niya. Number three, indemnification for the consequence of his actions. Okay, so tatlo ang cover ng civil liability. We are talking about delicts class, delicts or crime. The fourth source of obligation, delicts. So ito yung consequences. Ito yung mga obligations niya sa civil liability. So obligations arising from crime may require the person committing the crime to pay restitution, reparation, and indemnification. Okay. The fifth source of obligation are quasi delicts. Another term for quasi delicts is culpa aquiliana or so called torts. So huwag kayong malito niya na ang ibig sabihin ng quasi delict, culpa aquiliana, and torts. Pareho lang. Synonyms yan sila. Okay, this is are found under Article 2176 to 2194. Okay, what is a quasi delict? Is an act or omission by a person which causes damage to another. Okay? Nakadamage ka ng ibang tao. There being fault or negligence, kasi may fault ka, may negligence ka. And then there is no pre-existing contractual relationship between the parties. Wala kayong contract. Okay, tatlo yung class. Under sa quasi-delict, ang kaibahan ng delict sa quasi-delict class, ang delict crimes, pwede ka makulong. Sa quasi-delict class, okay, may fault ka lang na nag-cause ng damage to another, pero hindi siya crime. Example, okay, naglaro kayo ng basketball. Okay, tapos pinasa mo yung bola sa kasama mo, pero napalakas ang tapon mo ng bola, tumama sa bintana ng kapitbahay mo. Nasira mo yung bintana, nabiyak ang jealousy. Okay? Hindi ka naman makukulong nun kasi hindi naman yung crime. Pero meron kang fault or negligence na nakakause ka ng damage to another person. And then yung kapitbahay mo, wala ka namang kontrata sa kanya. Diba? So ang tawag sa ginawa mo, quasi-delict. Okay, kahit na walang crime, kahit na wala kang contract with the neighbors, you are still obliged to pay yung bitana na sinira mo. Okay? Yun sa quasi-delict class. Tawag sa kanya quasi-delict, parang delict siya dahil may negligence na nag-cause ang damage to another, pero hindi siya crime. And then there is no contractual relationship between the person na nakasira at saka yung taong na nasiraan niya. So, anong difference ng delicts sa quasi-delicts? Sa delicts class or sa crime, may malicious intent. May intent talaga. Okay? Magnakaw. May intent talaga siya magnakaw. Pero sa quasi-delict, negligence lang. Walang intention na malicious. Okay? Nasira mo yung bintana dahil nalakas na palakas yung tapon mo ng bola. Okay? Wala namang intention yun na magsira talaga. Kailangan may negligence. Sa crime class or sa delicts, ang purpose ng obligation niya is to punish him for the crime. While in quasi-delict, the purpose is indemnification. Ibig sabihin, bay, alam mo yung masira mo na bintana. Indemnify the person for the damages that you cause. In delicts class, public interest is affected. While in quasi-delict, private interest is affected. Pag sinabi public interest class, kunwari, nagnakaw ka, ibig sabihin, ang community ninyo, public interest, matatakot na sa'yo kasi baka nakawan mo rin sila. Okay? So, public interest ang involved sa crime. Okay, for example, nang rape ka, matatakot na ngayon ang community, baka rapin nyo rin ang mga babae sa kanila. Okay, so, public interest ang involved sa crime. While in quasi-delict class, private interest lang. Okay? Ang mag-worry lang is yung taong may-ari nung bintana na nabiak mo. Okay? Hindi naman mag-worry ang community na baka tapunan mo ng bola ng lahat ng bintana nila. So, private interest lang ang involved sa quasi-delicts. Number 4, in crimes class or quasi-delicts, the offender is liable criminally and civilly. Dalawa ang liability niya. Criminal, makukulong siya, and then pwede pa siya pagbayarin. While in quasi-delict, there is no criminal liability, walang kulong, pero you may be obliged to pay the damages you cause. So, ito class kasi culpa contractual, culpa criminal, culpa aquiliana. I-differentiate natin itong tatlo na ito class because sa board exam, itong tatlo na ito, pampagulo ito. Culpa class, culpa means negligence. Okay. May negligence kasi sa contract class. Halimbawa, nag-contract tayo. I will buy your cellphone for 10,000. Ang negligence sa contract class ganito, nag-deliver ka ng cellphone. Dinili-deliver mo ng cellphone sa akin, pero nasira mo yung screen kasi nadapa ka habang naglalakad. Okay? So, may negligence ka sa pag-deliver ng phone. Tapos, may contract tayo, existing contract. Yung negligence mo is related doon sa contract natin. That is why it's called culpa contractual. Negligence in the performance of contracts. Okay? In our case, na sinabi ko, okay, nag-deliver ka ng cellphone sa akin, binili kong cellphone mo for 10,000, diniliver mo sa akin, sira na yung screen dahil na, yun na, na dinanghag ka, you have been very, ang tawag nito, clumsy, the, okay, under our contract, you may be liable to pay me damages for delivering to me a cell phone with a cracked screen. That in relation to our contract. So, yun ang culpa contractual class. Culpa criminal, negligence sa, na criminal, will give rise to criminal obligation only if there is a law punishing it. Because there is no crime, there is no law punishing it. Okay, ganito. Diba sabi natin kanina, ang quasi-delict may negligence pero walang kulong. Quasi-delict yung kasa, hindi delict. Kasi ang criminal delict. Pero class, may mga negligence class na may batas na ginagawa siyang criminal. For example, nakabangga, nag-drive ka, nabangga mo yung tao, napatay, or nagkaroon ng physical injuries, or nakabangga ka ng isa pang sasakyan, nakasira ka ng properties ng ibang tao, or nabangga mo yung simento o yung gate. Okay? May batas kasi na nagpapanish, na ginagawang criminal yon. So, negligence yon na criminal. Hindi yung negligence na quasi-delict. Okay? Kaya nga, kasi under our criminal law class, sa criminal law, walang krimen kung walang batas na nagpapanish. Okay? So, ordinarily, yung negligence, yung quasi-delict na negligence class, yung nagtapon ka ng bola na nakasira ng bitana, walang kulong yon. Halimbawa lang, okay, yung Congress natin, gumawa ng bagong batas, ang sabi doon, okay, yung tao na magtapon ng, halimbawa lang, sabi doon sa batas, ang tao na makasira ng bintana dahil sa negligence sa pagtapon ng bola, ay makukulong. In that case, class, dahil may batas na nagpapanish doon sa negligence, na maging criminal yung negligence, Ang tawag ng class, culpa criminal na, hindi na quasi delict. Okay? So, ulitin ko. Normally, a negligence is not criminally, there is no criminal obligation sa quasi delict. Kasi nga, negligence lang yon na walang malicious intent. Okay? Pero kapag may batas na nagbabawal doon sa negligence na yon at nagpapanis doon sa negligence na yon, that will become now a culpa criminal. Negligence na criminal na. And because may batas na nagbabawal doon, okay, it becomes now a crime. Okay. So, culpa criminal is negligence na may batas na na ginagawa itong criminal. Example ng culpa criminal class is yung reckless driving causing damage or death, homicide ba, or physical injuries to another person. Okay, may batas dyan na bawal yan. So, although negligence siya, wala kang intention, aksidente lang nangyari, pero may batas kasi na nagsasabing criminal yan, dapat may punishment. So, nagiging culpa criminal siya. So if you encounter this Latin term, nullum crimen, nulla pena sine lege, ibig sabihin ng class, there is no crime if there is no law punishing it. So if a negligence has no crime that punishes it, it is only quasi delict. But if there is a law punishing it, then it becomes culpa criminal. Okay? Sa culpa criminal class, walang contract involved ba? Negligence lang, tapos may batas na nagbabawal. What is culpa criminal? Culpa criminal is quasi delicts or torts. Ito yung another name nila, culpa criminal. Culpa criminal is negligence that will become a source of obligation because of negligence na hindi criminal. So itong tatlong culpa na ito, class, take note of this. Balik-balik kasi ito sa board exam. Okay, i-recap ko lang. Culpa contractual, negligence sa performance ng contract. Contractual obligations, I mean. May contract siya na existing. Culpa criminal is negligence siya pa rin, kasi ang culpa meaning negligence. Okay? Na hindi sana crime, pero kay may law man na nagpapanish it as a crime, so nagiging culpa criminal. Walang contract dito, class, sa culpa criminal. Yung victim at saka yung negligent person, walang contract. Culpa criminal na class is the fifth source of obligation, which is also called quasi delicts or torts. Negligence ito, class, pero hindi siya pinapanish ng law. Ang example lagi dito, ang example ko palagi dito is yung natapon mong bola na nakabiyak ng bintana. Culpa criminal. So take note of these three culpas, ang difference nila.